Herta Oberheuser, Nazi German physician. She was born on 15th May 1911 in Cologne, German Empire. She received her medical degree in Bonn, Germany in 1937, specializing in dermatology. Soon, she joined the Nazi Party as an intern and later worked as a doctor for the League of German Girls. The League of German Girls was the girls' wing of the Nazi Party youth movement, the Hitler Youth. In 1940, she was appointed to serve as an assistant to Karl Gebhardt. Karl Gebhardt was the chief surgeon of the SS and Heinrich Himmler's personal physician. In 1942, Oberheuser and Gebhardt came to the Ravensbrück women's concentration camp in order to conduct experiments on its prisoners to find better methods to treat infections. Female prisoners were subjected to inhuman experiments at the Ravensbrück concentration camp. These experiments were performed by a group of doctors known as the Hohenlohe Group. Oberheuser was one of the members responsible for post-operative care of the victims. The group conducted several medical experiments on Ravensbrück prisoners, like sulfonamide experiments, bone, muscle, and nerve regeneration and transplantation. Ravensbrück sulfonamide experiments were performed to test the efficacy of sulfur drugs. The experiments actually happened because of the death of one of Hitler's close friends, high-ranking SS officer Reinhard Heydrich. Reinhard Heydrich, the chief of the Reich Security Main Office, who was one of the main architects of the Holocaust, the deportation and genocide of all Jews in German-occupied Europe. On 27th May 1942, Reinhard Heydrich was wounded in an assassination attempt on him. Himmler ordered Dr. Karl Gebhardt to treat Heydrich. Despite the serious injuries, Heydrich's recovery appeared to progress well. Hitler's personal doctor, Theodor Moral, suggested the use of the new antibacterial drug sulfonamide, but Gebhardt thought that Heydrich would recover and rejected the suggestion. Heydrich died on the 4th June 1942. Hitler blamed Gebhardt for refusing to prescribe sulfonamide drugs to treat Heydrich, which led to Heydrich's death. Himmler suggested to Gebhardt that he should conduct experiments to prove that sulfonamide was useless in the treatment of Heydrich. To justify his decision not to prescribe sulfonamide drugs to treat Heydrich's wounds, the experiments were performed by Nazi doctors, including Herta Oberheuser, on prisoners. Initially, experiments were conducted on male prisoners in the Sachsenhausen camp. As the prisoners resisted and became difficult to control, so they turned to women. The medical experiments were conducted on 86 women, 74 of whom were Polish prisoners. Five of them died as a direct result of the experiments. The brutal experiments left them with injuries and deformities. Jadwiga Dzido, a Polish resistance member, was one of the women subjected to forced medical experiments, along with several other women, to test the effects of sulfonamide drugs on wounds and bone transplantation experiments. Nazi doctors made incisions on her leg and deliberately infected her with bacteria, dirt, and glass splinters, much like an actual war wound. This caused her to suffer from severe pain, high fever, muscle atrophy, and unconsciousness for a long period of time. Many prisoners subjected to these medical experiments died from their wounds. As the Soviet Red Army rapidly approached in the spring of 1945, the SS decided to evacuate as many prisoners as possible, so as not to leave behind any witnesses who could testify to what happened in the camp. On April 30, 1945, Soviet forces liberated the Ravensbrück camp. Fewer than 3,500 malnourished and sick prisoners were found alive in the camp. After the end of World War II, Oberheuser was arrested and tried at the doctor's trial in Nuremberg, Germany. Among the 23 defendants, Oberheuser was the only female defendant in the Nuremberg doctor's trial. She was one of the members responsible for the post-operative care of the victims. Witnesses at the trial recalled that Oberheuser did nothing but make the prisoners' injuries worse. Another witness recalled that Oberheuser refused to give water to several victims, and when she did, it was mixed with vinegar. Jadwiga Dzido shows her scarred leg in the court. Expert medical witness Dr. Alexander explains the nature of the medical experiment performed on her in the Ravensbrück camp. Incisions were made on her leg, which was infected with bacteria, dirt, and glass splinters, just like an actual war wound. Oberheuser was convicted of crimes against humanity and sentenced to 20 years in prison. Her sentence was commuted to 10 years in January 1951, a benefit of widespread protests by West German citizens and politicians over the upcoming executions of the remaining 28 war criminals who were on death row under US military law. She served her sentence at Landsberg prison and was released in April 1952 for good behavior and became a family doctor in Stocksee, near Kiel in West Germany. In August 1958, Oberheuser was identified by a Ravensbrück survivor and lost her position when the Interior Minister of Schleswig-Holstein revoked her medical license and closed her practice. She appealed to the Schleswig-Holstein Administrative Court, which rejected the appeal in December 1960. She never practiced medicine again and was fined. Herta Oberheuser died on 24th January 1978 in a German nursing home in Linz am Rhein, West Germany, aged 66. Our channel, The Past Quest. We only post videos about history. If you find our video interesting, then like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.